Dear learners, I am Dr. Nita Lagacho Tayar, your academic counselor for the paper MEG03, which focuses on the British novel. Today, let us discuss the Polish-English novelist Conrad and his work Heart of Darkness. Heart of Darkness is one of the most emblematic works written by Conrad and occupies a paramount position in English studies. Its influence has transcended the literary context, one of the best examples of this phenomenon being Francis Ford Coppola's film Apocalypse Now, a version of Conrad's novella. A possible explanation for this success has been given by Robert Burden, who has said that Heart of Darkness is the ideal modernist set text, pointing out that although it is a brief work, it's full of different layers of meaning. Let me introduce you to Conrad. Joseph Conrad was born in 1857 in Poland. His father was actively involved in the revolutionary movement to bring independence to Poland. As a result, the Russian government kept Conrad's family from settling for long in one place. His mother died when he was 7 of tuberculosis. His father died of the same illness when he was only 11. His mother's brother took him into custody. 5 years later, Conrad moved to France to learn to sail. In 1878, he traveled to England and spent the next 20 years sailing on British ships. In 1889, Conrad began writing his first novel, Almayer's Folly. It was published in 1895. In 1890, Conrad was shocked by what he saw when he traveled in the Belgian Congo, a trip which gave him a severe illness and disillusioned him towards imperialism. The exploitation he observed there served as an inspiration for Heart of Darkness. Conrad married Jessie George in 1896, and she was 16 years his younger to him. Conrad wrote Heart of Darkness in 1898 and 1899, and it was published in 1902. He continued to write until he died of a heart attack in 1924. Joseph Conrad's Heart of Darkness belongs to the genre of the modern novella. The novella is a literary genre of written fiction. We can broadly say that a novella is shorter than a full-length novel, but longer than a short story. They are typically about 60 to 120 pages, or 7,500 to 40,000 words. The modern novella often illuminates individual experience, conveys inner consciousness, and focuses on the mystery of the universe, its lack of order and purpose. When Heart of Darkness was being written, Europe was undergoing great social changes and upheavals. This period marked the weakening of stable traditions and the questioning of imperialism. Idealism about imperialism, prevalent in the mid-1800s, was beginning to fall in Britain and Europe as the public slowly became aware of the injustices and exploitations. The Boer War, a brutal and costly struggle between the native South Africans and the British imperialists, broke out as Conrad wrote this novella. At the same time, Sigmund Freud was beginning his work on the id, the ego, and the superego. Now let's discuss about the plot of the novella, Heart of Darkness. Heart of Darkness begins on the Thames River and told by an unknown narrator. He and several other men are on the deck of a ship named Nelly when Marlowe, a riverboat captain, begins to speak. Marlowe had always wanted to travel to Africa and up the snake-like Congo River. With the help of his aunt in Brussels, Marlowe gets a job as a boat captain on the river with a Dutch trading company that deals in ivory. After getting his assignment at the office in Brussels, he travels to the mouth of the Congo River in a French steamer which drops off soldiers and clerks at many stations along the African coast. The sight of a French man of war firing at nothing puzzles Marlowe. When Marlowe arrives at the mouth of the Congo, a Swedish captain takes him to the company's inner station on a smaller boat. Outside of the inner station, he sees Africans chained and working hard at worthless projects, with others nearby dying slowly. Marlowe is impressed with the competence and dress of the accountant who works at this station. It is here, that is in the company's inner station, that he first learns of Kurtz, an exceptional trader who is destined for great things. Marlowe then travels to the company's central station, walking 200 miles inland with a sick, overweight white man who had to be carried by Africans until they tired of it and abandoned him. Once at the central station, Marlowe meets the general manager, a hollow man who got his job not by virtue of his merit, but simply by remaining alive. The general manager's only talent is to make people feel uneasy. The boat Marlowe was supposed to captain had been torn up in an accident just before he arrived, so Marlowe spends months at the station making repairs and waiting for rivets. Rivets means like nails, screws, fasteners, etc. So the supplies are, since the supplies are short. During this time, Marlowe notices that many of the white men do no work and work aimlessly. One day, a building caught fire and the white men decided to punish an African for it. Marlowe then meets another hollow man, the brick maker, who has no materials to build bricks. The brick maker questions Marlowe about his connections in Europe, and Marlowe learns more about Kurtz, who is, besides being an excellent trader, an artist, and is in Africa for the purpose of bringing light to the natives. Marlowe determines that the brickmaker is a spy for the manager and that neither likes Kurtz. The mysterious Kurtz whets Marlowe's curiosity more and more. He overhears the manager and the manager's corrupt uncle express their hatred and jealousy towards Kurtz, who is rumored to be ill. With the repairs complete, Marlowe captained the boat upriver, manager on board, towards Kurt's station. He employed the help of a group of cannibals who refrained from eating anyone in his presence. Just before arriving at Gert's station, a tribe of Africans attacked the ship, and his African helmsman was killed, having lost his self-control. At this point, Marlowe worries that he may never meet Gertz, but they find Gertz's station upriver. Greeted by a young Russian, Marlowe finds out that Gertz is very ill. He also finds out that Gertz convinced a tribe he was a deity to use them to get more ivory. Gertz goes crazy and runs for the woods, devoid of all restraint. Marlowe finds him and helps him back to his bed. Gertz gives Marlowe some papers to give to the people in Europe. Gertz eventually dies, uttering, quote, the horror, unquote. Marlowe returns to Europe, delivers the papers, and eventually talks to Gert's fiancée. She is still very idealistic, and he cannot tell her about Gert's last words, saying instead, Gert's uttered her name before dying. So that's the plot of the novella. And now let us just come to Conrad's style. The way he wrote his narrative, Heart of Darkness. Conrad's language is often characterized by balanced phrases and parallel structures. He interprets his narrative with long poetic descriptions of natural scenes. There are those who criticized him for his verbosity, his word choice, phrasing, and length of sentence, but these are characteristics that add beauty to his prose.